Yo, what's going on everybody? It is that time for another video, and today's video we are going to be talking about will the Bleach anime be good? Because obviously I think a lot of people are worried about, you know, whether Periot's going to have it, whether another studio is going to have it, whether there's enough time, when it's going to be released. And so hopefully by this conversation, at the end of it, you will feel a bit more confident in about the position that it may or may not be in, depending on whatever's in your head, I suppose. And today, with me, I have a very good friend of mine, Roe. Do you want to give yourself a quick hello?
Hello, guys. My name is Roe. I'll be talking with James for, I don't know how long we'll be talking, but it should be interesting, right?
So Roe actually knows a lot more about the industry and a lot more about in-betweens than I do, or can correct me on a lot of things if I get wrong, basically. So, and this is basically to have a discussion with someone who I talk to on a daily basis about the industry and committees and the workings of inside and out the industry. So hopefully you guys can learn something as well as me when we have this discussion. So that's what it is. Nothing is factual in this video. I'm not going to allude that anything is happening. It is just to ease any kind of misconceptions that you guys might have about whether Bleach will be good or not. And hopefully, yeah, we can achieve that. So I kind of want to start off with pre-production. Now, pre-production is obviously the part before production, and it's very important because you need to have, I believe anyway, a good pre-production before you can go into production. Would you agree?
Pre-production, I think it's important that Bleach, for it to be good, it needs a lot of time before the production starts. Because sometimes a product can end up being rushed if they don't have enough time to work with.
What kind of skills, like not skills, but like what kind of roles do we need in pre-production? Like what's the job of pre-production before production?
Well, the pre-production, it's mostly planning. Planning of how stuff is going to be done. So we have like, they need the storyboards to work with, and they need to know like what the different roles are in the production, like who's going to do what, and they get this sorted before they can obviously start working on the episodes.
So is that like the director's job, right?
Yes, it's the director's job and the core team around him, the top roles of the production. And I think in Bleach's case, it's in a presumably positive situation because there's so much time between when they first planned for this to happen and when it's actually going to air, because they've wanted to do this for a long time, as we already know. So I think before the main production of the series is going to happen, like in the actual episodes are going to be animated and the voice actors come in and all that, we need to get the pre-production sorted, and I believe that Bleach is in the best possible situation it could be in for that.
I think what's going to be really good, especially, you know, if we're doing the hypothetical sense that this is Periot, many people are going to have like the bad misconception of like, oh well, look what they did to Black Clover, or oh, look what they did to Boruto. Even though I personally don't think Naruto was ever that well done, besides like Naruto versus Sasuke are the big peak moments personally to me. Black Clover obviously has, as you know, has had a lot of flack for how it's looked and how it's been treated. The context there obviously is because, you know, TV Tokyo keep adding episodes, so they're not really sure on, you know, where the end goal is. And I think we can talk about that much more shortly after. But wasn't there a series recently by Periot called Akamaru Drive, which looked really good?
Yeah, Akudama Drive, yeah. Oh, sorry, it's by the written by the creator of the Danganronpa series. Yeah, and that looks pretty good, I'd say. It's a very unique style and all that. And we know that Piero can do really good work, as we saw with the Bleach anime itself. Most people in the industry and outside the industry would agree that the Bleach anime was a very good product. Mm-hmm. And by that I mean that it was consistent, more so than any of the other big three, I'd say.
Is that due to the director or just the outsourcing of other studios, like from like Shaft and people from like Toei? Do you think like they really contributed to the series?
I think that some of the roles, like Abe being on there, I think Abe kept a tight grip on Bleach. I think any production that Abe has been involved in has been super consistent, honestly. And I believe that there's a good chance, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but I feel like Abe would take the chance to work on Bleach again.
I think so too. I think he's very like invested into it. We was having a conversation about the idea of like, you know, like something like Black Clover. Because obviously loads of people right now are praising how well the filler arc is at the moment. And I think, you know, I never really watched Naruto fillers, so I don't know if they were really good quality or not. But like Bleach fillers, they were mad. They're absolutely mad. And the question is, obviously, I think you can answer this one, is like, why do fillers always look so good?
Well, always is a strong word, but And I think that has to do with the fact that it's original, right? The studio is making this from the ground up. So imagine that with a manga, you have this formula you need to follow. You have this strict guideline of this is going to happen, this is going to happen. These characters are moving like this. But in filler, you can go original from the beginning with, like from the scratch, right? And you can set up scenarios that work out the best for you in the animation. So I feel like they just take use of the original setting and just keep adding to that to best suit their qualifications.
I feel like as a director, like it's really hard, especially like if a series is ongoing, and you obviously you know how to begin it, because obviously the start of the manga is there, you know what content you need to do, you kind of have an idea of like who you want to say, okay, I want this team of animators working on this scene, I want this team of animators working on that scene, right? But then again, like as the manga goes on, and obviously with the old system of like long ongoing shonen, like you don't know what's going to happen in that next chapter. Something big might happen, but depending off it, like especially Black Clover, where it's like really close to like the Spade arc, right? Mm. Like imagine them going into it like not knowing what animators to put on what fight, because they don't know what's gonna be like a fan favorite, they don't know what's gonna be the most prioritized bit of that arc, and thus you have like a really disorganized team. And obviously now that Bleach is obviously completed, they have something from beginning, middle and end. They know like what animators to put on what fight, they know what to focus more on, like okay, is this like a big massive part that we need to put a lot of budget into, but a lot of time and effort into in comparison to like this scene, for example. And I think that's why for the majority of the part, or like a more common sense of the imagination, is that that's why like fillers look good, right? And that's why I have no problem with like Bleach being done by a studio like Periart, because like at least if it has a good direct, which I'm pretty sure, like, I agree with you, like, Abe would shoot up to the opportunity. And it's going to be really interesting to see what director we do get for Bleach. As long as I think the pre-production will do well, because look how long it's been, dude. It's like, it got announced, like, when? Like, Anime Japan. And we knew about it, like, since, like, at least December 2019. So we're almost for a sure, year yeah. in. So, like, I mean, that's good. Because usually when something gets announced, a year later it usually happens and comes to us, right? So we're getting more time than like the majority of anime series, except for One Punch Man. That's a bit different story, but
yeah,
like,
as you said that's a massive positive with Bleach, the fact that it's completed. They know the amount of chapters they need to do, they know the content. So in this, like in the pre-production phase, like they'll have a much easier time than if they had to work on something that's ongoing. Obviously, like when you start a production from the beginning, like you have completed chapters that you're still going off. But with this, they've had a lot of time to think of how to do it, and a lot of people that are interested in doing it, because Bleach is a super successful franchise, right?
And you're not stressing about like, oh, how many chapters are we animating this week? Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure like One Piece had that problem where it was like, we're gonna animate an episode per chapter, and I like they dragged it on. I mean, like, come on, bro, the 5-minute intros or the 5-minute recaps, bro, like, and the 2-minute intros, like, you've wasted like 7 to 10 minutes alone just like getting into the episode, and then like what, 10 maybe 15 minutes of like content afterwards. Like it's just not viable, right? So at least like whoever's directing it can look at Bleach and be like, okay, we're gonna animate 3 chapters here, we'll animate 1 chapter there, we'll animate 2 there. Like he's got free reign without being picky and choosy about like, oh, we got to be careful here, we don't want to get too close to the manga. Because in the Fullbring arc, what many people don't know is that, yes, in the interview stages where Bleach ended in its Fullbring arc towards the end, the Bleach manga was only 3 chapters ahead. Many people don't take into consideration that, actually, think about when those episodes were actually made. They were probably made like weeks or months in advance. So like it wasn't actually behind the manga. It was actually way ahead of the manga. And that's why Kubo had to come in and tell him what happened. So in that regard, like they don't have to stress about that now. And I'm pretty sure like in the pre-production phase, I would like to think, and hopefully we get that announcement that Kubo does add in extra content. That'd be epic, honestly. Like I'd really love that. But getting off the topic,
just to like jump in there, and I think the idea of extra content is also great, because that's, there's nothing visual there with the novels, for example, if they want to add in some of that. And then we have like the same situation as an original like filler episode or something like that, because they don't have any visuals to work with, so they can like best make it suited to how they want to visually present it, rather than trying to imitate Kubo's style, you know? So I think there's a lot of potential in this production.
Obviously, do you think personally that they've spent a good amount of time on pre-production?
It seems like they've had all the time they could possibly dream of, compared to other projects that are being rushed out because they need to make like in time for the volume release of this and that, or like in time for the ending. Like make an example of Attack on Titan, right? We needed to happen like by the end of 2020, or like we needed to happen very soon because the manga is about to end and we want to time this correctly.
It's that it's monthly too, it's like god.
Yeah, and like they don't know exactly when it's going to end, right? So it's like, oh yeah, we're struggling with this, so we really want it to happen now, and therefore they might encounter some production issues because of that, because the TV network wants it to air then and so on.
Yeah, they get really greedy.
This situation doesn't seem to exist with Bleach, because they shouldn't really be in any rush to get the Bleach anime out.
And it doesn't seem like that's the case either. Like, let's do another hypothetical, right? Say it comes out like late 2021 or even early 2022, right? Mm-hmm. Let's put that into consideration. Hopefully it's the latter. You know, many people are like, oh, 2022, I don't want to wait, blah, blah, blah. But however, would you prefer obviously more time into a production than have it sooner? I mean, I think we've had enough time anyway, honestly. I think at the moment, since hearing the news and where we are today, I think, say, for example, we got it just like Eden Zero, right? We got the Eden Zero announcement in, what was it? It was around, well, I knew about it around about spring, right? And we got the announcement around about, I want to say September, August, right? And it was announced for spring 2021. That's like a good year that was going to happen. So like, let's say that's pre-production and production, right? Let's say hypothetically. And if that does well, and I think that's going to be like a good, like, for me personally, that's going to be like a good example. Because if that looks good, that goes to show, okay, this is like a nice little standard. Even though I shouldn't, but for me personally, it will be like a nice little standard of how well things are gonna look. Even though obviously there can be loads of different complications, as we know from like Attack on Titan, for example, because of how close it is to the end of the year that's airing. That to me is a good standard, like a year. So again, if that's good, then that's awesome. So if we get that to, say for example, we get that late 2021, I think we're gonna have a good adaptation. What do you think?
Yeah, and I think that we could kind of use Eden Zero as an example of like what might happen to Bleach in terms of direction, or the director, because like this is just like, again, hypothetical, like a imaginary scenario in terms of like who's directing this and that. So Fairy Tail's director like came on Eden Zero to work on that. However, he's taken a role as, I don't remember the exact term, but he's kind of the chief director, right? And
lead
in
director,
this,
maybe something like that.
Yeah, and then they have like a new director touched on Fairy Tail before, and now he's kind of the main director for the series, even though the old Fairy Tail director is the chief. And that's because the chief director wanted a new spin on the series.
Yeah,
he didn't want to.
Right?
Yeah, exactly. He needed new eyes on it. Maybe Abe wants to be involved, but maybe he also thinks that we need some new eyes on this. So maybe
I think he'd be aware that, like, nostalgia as well as new fresh blood to it. I think that's fine.
So maybe, like, because in Eden Zero's case, the old fairy tale main director is kind of like overseeing, like, this. He's kind of like a creative director. He's like saying, like, this is how I wanted to go. Like, we're going to do this and that. And the director himself is the one that, like, puts it into practice, right? It's him that does, like, how they're going to make sure the episodes are done, right? Like, I want this kind of vision on it. So he's, like, the ones that puts things into practice, while the chief director is more like a theoretical, like, this is the groundwork of what I want to be done and make sure this is happening, right? So maybe Abe might be this, like, overseeing figure of the new Bleach anime rather than the practical director, right?
I think when it comes to these kind of projects, for, like, say Bleach is going to come back 9 years from when it last aired, or 10 years from when it last aired, I don't think it really matters. I think what matters is that this is the chief editor of Shueisha at the moment, or Shonen Jump, Nakano. He's putting his time and money into this project, right? And I think it'd be very ignorant of anyone to say that, like, they'd be worried about how this is going to go down, because they don't want a failure of a product. They obviously want it to succeed. Given the time that it is taken at the moment, and it's not being rushed out the door like Seven Deadly Sins, unfortunately, goes to speak volumes, honestly, on, like, how well it can probably be here. You know, they probably want a new influx of manga sales. They probably want a new influx of merchandise. They want longevity. And I that's what I personally am getting from this anyway, because you're looking at minimum a 4-core. At minimum, if it's seasonal.
And I think, like, this is going to make for a new age of Bleach. They're going to, with the anime, they need to take advantage of that, right? They're not just going to do an anime for the sake of it. I think that it would make sense, like, if you look at it from a business mindset, such as, like James knows, it's that with an anime, you have all this marketing, right? So why not throw in, like, a game with that? Why not throw in extra novels with that? Like, you want the sales, right?
I think it's the most common practice to have a game with a new anime release. It seems like that's the formula that happens now.
Yeah, so I have nothing to be other than excited, you know?
And again, you got to think about it too. Like, let's just say contracts are on the table now. This is for a, you know, as I said, this is a minimum 4-core, right? Because you're kind of taking into example, you know, you got 200 chapters, right, of the Thousand-Year Blood War arc. You got, you know, 480 all the way to 686, right? You got over 200 chapters here. You know, 2 chapters an episode. You look like, if it's a 25 episode per core, 2 chapters per episode, you're looking at, like, 4 cores here. 200, I can't even, that's 100 episodes, right?
Yeah, 100 episodes.
Yeah, 100 episodes. That's a big investment. That's a lot of money that you have to pay. What's the average for an anime episode now? Like 100,000, 200,000 per episode? It's a big investment. And
even more sometimes.
Yeah, even more sometimes. And I think this is why TV Tokyo do the thing with Black Clover. So, like, they can back out at any time, right? And I think that's why a lot of anime are seasonal now. So, like, many of these TV stations can just back out at any time if it's not worth it for them. They're not obliged to do more episodes, right? They're not obliged to stick to it. But again, this is a 2-year, you know, this is assuming that it's going to carry on, you know, on a, if it's seasonal, if it's continuous, you know, you look into a year to 2 years. That's a long investment, and that's a lot of money you're going to lose. So of course they're going to make it good. You know, it'd be preposterous not to, I think.
Knowing this, that they want the Bleach anime to be really good, right? And I'm sure there's so many people that love Bleach, like, people there's new animators in Japan that grew up on Bleach. There's the old staff members such as Kudo, which I'm sure he would jump at the chance to work on Bleach again. He loves that, like, he loves anything, yeah, you know. I have nothing but, like, a positive outlook on how this can turn out, right?
And I think with the current market of Shonen Jump too, is like a lot of new series are coming and going. They don't last as long as the previous big three did. So I think, you know, they want a longevity series. They want something that's going to keep putting money in their back pocket while these new series come and go until they can have a more solidified ground. I mean, My Hero Academia is that one, but I think they've got to think of like their business prospects of not putting all their eggs in one basket. So I think Bleach is a very good example of that. And I think TV Tokyo as well as Periop, again, hypothetically, if they do own it, and we're going on the consensus that nothing has changed, I don't think Boruto will be staying that long either. I think it was only like last year that we were talking about, like, we've only possibly got 2 years left of it. So that was the manga. So from my perspective, I think it's going to be good, and I don't think people should worry, to be honest with you. Anything to add? Any like last thoughts?
No, not really. I feel like we've covered most bases. If there's any questions, of course, just shoot them to James, you know, and we might follow up on this.
Obviously, join the Discord, and we'll discuss it. We'll talk about it, and obviously, it is. There's a lot to talk about. I think, like, and I think the closer we get to Jump Fest, or the closer we get to more information being revealed about directors, we can start looking at their past works. We can start looking at like the committee. We can start looking at the animators and their past works. So I'm very excited, to be honest with you. I'm not scared that it's going to be bad. If anything, I'm more worried about the censorship and the time slot that it will have. But then again, I think that's kind of minimalistic when you think about like the Blu-rays will like correct any censorship anyway, or streaming. So I'm not worried in the slightest. Tell us your thoughts in the comment section down below, guys. Of course, smack that fucking like button. And there's a Discord in the description down below. Follow me on Twitter, all that sort of stuff. And thank you. Thank you for joining, bro.
Yeah, no problem, bro.
I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been a hands-on as always, people. Peace out.